Ideally, Dan would like to start his own consulting company, but without a job, it's difficult to pay for launching a new business. Joining us now is career coach Chrissy Sivek. She's someone, we're going to be talking about someone as qualified as Dan here, Chrissy. He's willing to do all the grunt work.
Right.
But how can a company hire him? What can he do to make them hire him?
Well, first off, it's really important that you know why you want this position, not just why you need it. It's so easy to get really focused on the fact that you need the paycheck. But what is it about this position that really excites you? What's going to get you out of bed in the morning to go do this work? That's really the question on the mind of the hiring manager, right? They're looking at you and they're thinking, gosh, how am I going to keep this highly qualified person engaged and motivated to do this kind of work?
They look at it as a risk, right?
Absolutely. Answer that question for them.
And also express your desire to learn some new skills, perhaps.
Right. Regardless of your qualifications, your background, your history, your education, there's always more to learn. There is always room for growth in every single position at every single level. So you want to make sure that your interviewer understands that you get that and you're really excited about learning some new things in this role.
Now, as far as long-term goals, what do you want to tell the potential employer?
Right, this is kind of like the big pink elephant in the room. You want to go ahead and talk about it. Here you are, this highly qualified individual. You're looking at taking a lower level position. You're probably not going to be earning what you're really worth. So no one thinks you're going to stick around forever. So go ahead and let them know that you are looking to be a long-term part of this company. And in this position, you really want to prove yourself, show your willingness to be a team player for as long as it takes, and that ultimately you do hope to have some internal opportunities for growth along the way.
One of the other things people might look at as an easier option than going through all of that is to just dumb down their resume. Is that ever a good idea?
You know, it's never a good idea to misrepresent yourself in any sort of professional setting. So just remember that HR managers rarely find that perfect 100% fit. People come in and they're either underqualified or overqualified. So you're really in the better position here. You bring all of these qualifications with you and you're really kind of a bargain right now. You come at a fraction of the cost. So walk in with confidence and just be true to yourself.
Chrissy, thanks you so much for being here this morning. Great
advice. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right, well, if you